Hey there, and welcome back. If you were to ask me what is the most important thing that you should do in your lawn every year, this would be it. I'm talking about applying insecticide. And you know what? It's one of the most overlooked aspects of lawn care. No matter how nice your yard is, there is no way that you can truly enjoy it if you've got insects all over the place. So let me show you how you can keep those insects out of your lawn for good. I will show you my method that's worked well for me, and I know it's going to work well for you as well. Bugs are everywhere, but if you're seeing them in your lawn, there's going to be more where that came from. It's a sign of deeper problems that we've got to address. Bugs are going to stay there unless you address it. We moved to this place a few years back, and my yard was crawling with all kinds of different insects. There were anthills that would continue to pop up all the time, and I was constantly having to knock them down with my mower. And every time I would do that, every time I stomped one down, another one would pop back up shortly after. Not only that, it was making my yard unlevel, and it was causing additional wear and tear on my lawnmower. There were times where we'd be out in the yard playing with the kids, and it was a regular thing for us to find ticks on us afterwards. You also have insects like grubs and army worms that will quickly destroy your lawn if it's left unattended. So we want to make sure that that doesn't happen. But I've got an easy way to keep insects out of your lawn. It requires a little bit of diligence, but we have to be proactive. I suggest that you put down a product like this bag of Spectracide, which is a granular product. I've used this product for a couple years now, and I can tell you that it works really well. And it's a cheap and effective way to keep those insects out of our lawn. This one bag covers the entire yard. When you're putting out this product, you should distribute the granulars evenly with a broadcast or rotary spreader. After we get the product in the yard, we want to water it immediately after the application. Once the area has been treated and the water and all has dried, it is safe for the children and the pets to return to the lawn. I just want to mention that you should only use this product in grass and in flower beds. Even though on the label it says it's acceptable to be used in gardens, I don't suggest it. But make sure that your spreader is sending those granulars into your flower beds because you know what? There's going to be insects that are in there as well. We really don't want to miss those areas near our house. The timing of the applications is really important as well because based on what time of the day, what time of the year, that all matters. Speaking of timing, I'm coming out with a lawn care guide that focuses on warm season grasses, and I'm so pumped to announce that I'm going to be launching a Lawn Labs Insider newsletter. In this newsletter, you get access to pro tips and recommendations and so much more. I'm not going to spam you, I promise. It's just premium lawn care knowledge delivered right to your inbox. So if you want the inside scoop on what I'm doing to my lawn on a regular basis, sign up on the list. So let's take our lawns to the next level together. It's now time to get out the spreader. The first application of the year should be early in the spring when the weather is just starting to warm up and the grass, if you're in the south, is just starting to come out of its dormancy and turn green. So if you have Bermuda like me, that's the time that those insects are going to start moving. Once you get that first application down, then you're going to want to reapply after every 2 to 3 months. And make sure you stick with this schedule. But if you start to notice insects coming back into the lawn, go ahead and put down another application. And if you miss the first application window, it's not a big deal. I would say go ahead and get some and put it out right away. Then just put it out a couple months later after that first application. With these regular applications, we're going to be removing the primary food source from animals like snakes and raccoons, possums, skunks, and squirrels. Yeah, that was an odd one too. Skunks and squirrels, they go after insects too. We also have chipmunks and moles. We don't want any of those in our yard. Through the warmer months of the year, ants will be ever present if they're not dealt with swiftly. Now, if you've got some insects that sneak through your first line of defense, go ahead and put more insecticide down immediately. There are particular times of the year that you're going to deal with different kinds of insects. In the spring, it might be grubs, and if you're working in the flower beds in the early springtime and you dig into the ground and you see a grub, it's time to put down an application. If it's in the late summer or early fall, you might see army worms. If you stick to the schedule, you won't have to worry about these things ever again. Speaking of reading the label, I did that and I learned something. You can actually use this product on anthills if they pop up. But let's talk about ants for a moment. Sometimes they're the most difficult insects to manage. And here in Georgia, they become really active in spring, but particularly active in the late summer. So if you see an anthill pop up, that's when you put down the ant killer. As we wrap up, we want to get the hose out and we want to spray off our spreader. We don't want to have all that insecticide getting everywhere else in our garage. Then I'm going to make sure I spray off my shoes. And sometimes it'll get on the lower part of our pants, so we want to spray that off as well. And once we're done with that, we need to head straight for the showers. Even though this Spectracide granular works well, I will still put down a spray insecticide outside of this barrier that we're already putting down. And I stick to the same schedule that I do with putting down this granular product. And that way I'm not going to forget. And again, it's creating that natural barrier to our home. That way we are protecting our house from insects. The best way we can do that is to extend the distance that they have to travel to get inside of our home. So if you keep to the schedule, following these tips, it'll make it where your house is an insect-free zone. Just imagine how nice it would be if you were to lounge outside on a sunny day without having to deal with those annoying bugs pestering you. No more having to check for ticks every time you come inside the house. So get ready to reclaim your yard from those nasty little creatures and start truly enjoying your outdoor living space again.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.